Kentucky is not known as a hockey state, but you wouldn't know on a Friday at midnight in Lexington Ice Center.
Hockey state is surprising to see the amount of people that show up to the games and the atmosphere.
Oh yeah, for the fact that Kentucky's not like kind of known for hockey and like, you know, it's a little bit more of a southern state that you don't see have like, you know, a lot of like NHL players come out of, or even D1 players in general. Like, you know, you see the hotbeds in, you know, the East Coast, obviously, but then also, you know, even Illinois, the West Coast, stuff like that. So seeing the atmosphere and the amount of people that go to these games in Kentucky is very impressive. And, you know, you don't even see that in, you know, a lot of other colleges in these hotbeds for hockey. You don't see all these people going to games in.
UK hockey didn't start until 1984 and had a much different feel from what it does today. With low attendance, the rink pushed back the games until midnight. This would change everything. This surprisingly saw the attendance skyrocket, and the popularity of the sport on campus too as well.
O'clock games, that's genius. That's so smart for a college town. I mean, how do you get, you know, a bunch of kids to care about, you know, a sport that, you know, it's not huge in Kentucky, and especially like a club sport. It's not D1, which, you know, maybe, yeah, if it's a D1, you get a lot of people to go, but to get, you know, whoever came up with the, you know, midnight games, that's so smart. And I think that plays into how many people go to these games. You know, it's something different. It's something, yeah, it's midnight, and it gives people something to do. And, you know, you look at it compared to, like, I look at it and I'm like, oh, this honestly reminds me of, like, you know, small town, the atmosphere in like the small towns in Europe where they're going to their soccer games. They like, you know, live and die by their team. That's kind of the atmosphere and like, you know, going to these games, it feels like that. It feels like, you know, it's not the biggest, it's not the best, but, you know, people care about it.
The next decade saw the Cool Cats' record improve after each given season. It was to the point where they had to move up a division to face better opponents. By 2020, the Cats had to move up another division to the ACHA, only two steps away from the NCAA Division I. With Kentucky being ranked 6th in the entire nation, what is next for Kentucky hockey?
I mean, you see it at a D1 level with, you know, Arizona State, ASU, and how like their team has come from, you know, I think they went from D like 3 or to D1, and they've got amazing crowd at their games, and it's also a spot where you don't, you know, think there'd be a lot of people going. It's not a hotbed for hockey.
Even with the number of fans and their performances on the ice, it is still unlikely that Kentucky will go up another level. But time will tell, and it has happened before.
Betty watching every day they cock him. Huh? What? Every day they clock at me. Police steady watching me. Every day they clock at me. Red alert, I'm the dangerous. I keep that clock on me. And they ain't looking for no trouble. I'm just looking out for me. Cause I done did shit the niggas ain't talking about no rapping beat. Boy, I'm talking tragedy. Masking, casual. Shit that I can't even remember. Bet they remember me. Shit that happened late in December. I bring that winning. I'm in the streets, we play for keeps. 2011, August 11th. R.I.P.O.D. August 9th, 2 days before, I turned 17, 21 to 45. I'm like, what the fuck that mean?
You fighting an armed robbery, shorty. That's what they offering.